All right.
Are we live?
We're unmuted.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, welcome back to Three Monkeys, everyone.
We're playing Outlast.
Yep. Brad, have you got your music up yet?
Yep.
Got it queued up?
This time, I'm blindfolded.
And you can't see that Brad hasn't even chosen something yet. Brad, I thought you said you were almost ready.
He's working.
You're not supposed to be talking.
Well,
it's the intro. I'm Andrew. Go ahead.
He's Brad.
Yeah, I'm Brad.
Okay. So, Brad is Hear No Evil today. Chris is See No Evil. And I'm Speak No Evil. So once I start the game, I will no longer be speaking. Brad. Are we good to go? Brad, are we good to... Ah. Okay. You're not supposed to hear me. Okay. All right. So, I will no longer be speaking. Starting now.
So, I played a little bit of Outlast. I only know about, like, the little bit of the start and a little bit of the plot after all the praise about it, so.
I'm just gonna make sure that I'm gonna listen in on the audio and make sure I cannot hear the music playing through these headphones. Hopefully not. I can't hear shit anyways.
What's funny, so technically I'm playing two and a half roles. I'm playing See No Evil, but I'm hard of hearing, so I can barely hear what Brad said.
Yeah, Chris can...
But yeah, so this game, what I remember, you're a journalist who decided, I'm just gonna go into the state penitentiary or whatever. And turns out all the inmates have gotten loose and started killing each other, killing guards, killing doctors. And gets spooky real quick, if I remember.
Mm-hmm.
I think you're supposed to break into the, like, the right-hand side of the... Like, there's a bunch of scaffolding. I think that's what gets you inside.
I have no clue what is going on right now in the game. I haven't really been paying attention, to be honest. Andrew seems lost.
Sounds like you're still outside, Andrew.
Already seems to figure out where to go.
Look for scaffolding, Andrew. Game. I know that.
I don't really know much about them, to be honest. Horror games really aren't my cup of tea.
Because there's an open window, if I remember right, and that's the way in.
It's really hard for me to not want to go ahead and sing along to these, to the music that I'm listening to. But obviously I'm not gonna.
I was gonna look at my phone, but I was like, no, my eyes are closed, I'm blindfolded, I can't look at my phone, and I was gonna try to type it Brad. Andrew. Get your phone and write a message for me. I need you to write a message to Brad, tell him to describe the game more.
Oh, this is so much better for me when you're not the one blindfolded. You actually do shit.
Did you get in yet? I'm gonna assume you're saying no. Clap three times for yes. Okay.
What the hell just happened? What the hell's gonna happen if he gets a frickin' phone call from you know who?
Oh, we'll have to.
So I'm not gonna be able to hear that. Yeah, I guess that would work.
Okay.
Ah, fucking hell.
I hope that answers your question. We did not plan for that. It'd be easier for Brad to reach the mute key than I would, because I'll be like doing this thing for a moment. I mean, it'd be easier for you to, Andrew, just to run back to really the Brad's you messing bedroom, with the really. Fucking
soundboard when you can't see shit.
I would make more sense for you just to run out of the room.
Yeah, I can't hear him.
You get a phone call. I cannot
hear what he is saying at all right now. He's just looking over at Andrew saying something. It's like just a one-way conversation, pretty much. For the three of us. Chris might say something to Andrew, but Andrew can't respond. And I can't hear shit.
Hopefully Brad's looking at the game. Cause I sure ain't. Reminds me of Good Mythical Morning. As you can really see, we can't.
Christ.
Well, what's the volume? That.
Turn the TV down a bit. Set in here. Probably be playing Planet Zoo right now, but I kind of that game is pretty resource intensive.
I think one of the most annoying parts
going on right now. No way I'd risk that while we're live on air.
Okay. I think you stopped talking. I think the most annoying part about this game, Andrew, is probably having to find batteries. Because that's for your camera to. Mainly for the night vision features. Oh, hey, Andrew, if there's any viewers or new viewers, tap me, and I'll tap Brad. That way, he can interact with the audience.
Little fake.
Have you died yet? Have you met a creepy doctor yet?
I see. Merciful God, you have sent me an apostle. Guard your life, son. You have a calling.
Because there's this doctor that shows up that cuts your fingers off. You'll know him when you see him because he has giant scissors. I don't know if he's related to the Scissor Man from Clock Tower. What?
Oh, yeah. I'm not even sure what is going on right now. So he's in some of the insane asylum? Seeing shit.
Music right now reminds me of when that sound they play, like something's drawing in. Okay, now the music's changing. Just trying to describe the game from just the noise. Did Fred do a lousy job describing the game? He's probably over there playing Planet Zoo. From the sound of it. I'm right.
I want to know what the hell you're laughing at right now.
I think the earliest I don't know how to describe it. The earliest tough encounter that you have in this game is fairly off early in the game. There's like a doorway that's kind of blocked by like desk or something. And there's this very large man that kind of chases you down between that area. why. It felt like it sounded like you were trudging through water. And then there is a part in the game where you do have to kind of get through water. Like waist deep water. Yeah, I thought. So the reason this game was chosen out of between this one and the sequel, I think this one's more safe for Twitch compared to the sequel. But that's just personal opinion. Because the second one. Very, it dwells a lot in I don't know if it's safe for Twitch if I talk about it, right? I'm just gonna wait till off stream to talk about it. If people want to know what happens in the game, they can look it up themselves. What I can talk about is the fact that it's a pair of reporters this time on a helicopter that crashes. And the husband that you play as is trying to find his wife, who's been collected / kidnapped by the local cult or whatever. Nothing to do, I don't think it has anything to do with this game. Whistleblower might have something to do with it. I don't know. Never played it. Nor have I seen people play it. So as of late, I've been having Andrew's problem with video games. He calls the video game ADHD. There's too many games to play, don't know which one he wants to continue on first. I'm perplexed with finishing Fallout 4, but Persona 5 Royal just came out on multiple platforms, and I have it on my Steam Deck.
Who's there?
Kind of being quiet for dialogue. At least trying to. I might have spoke over some earlier. But right now, in Persona 5 Royal, I've just completed the second palace, which is the main dungeons of the game. The only thing is, I'm like, man, I ought to finish Persona 4 Golden. It has nothing to do with the game, even though it's... It's called Persona 5, isn't it? Not a sequel that ties in, really. But then also, I'm fixed on finishing Fallout 4 so I can play The Outer World with all of its DLC. Bad I have I have an idea. I think it's funny, but it's just a mean joke. Andrew, you're not responding to me. I have no idea what you just said. But I'm going to assume you agree with me. Okay, he agrees with me.
Son of a... I'm not even paying attention right now.
Does that sound like something coming for you, or it was a machine? Because like that banging sound like either a lousy elevator or something like hitting like a hammer against a surface as he's approaching. I don't remember the big guy having a hammer at the start of the game. He was just a big brute. He had the face only a mother can love. Lean back a little. Hunched over. Something happened.
Yeah, he's a stick.
Yep, he's dead. How did he die?
Good job, Andrew.
Played a song from that one game that sings, "You Are Dead."
I found it live for 35 minutes.
Who's there?
That music that was playing before you died, it sounded like very cliche chase music. One thing I'm just now thinking, I forget how, like, checkpoints, save points work in this game. There's the pounding noise again.
Ooh.
I'm just gonna stare at Brad's direction until he finally says something to me. Chase music.
Like you died again.
Andrew, you're not supposed to die. I can't give you any help. Brad should be the one helping you, saying something, giving opinions.
Just taking the time to upload a video since I didn't really have much else to do at this point.
The circumstances, Andrew. Have you tried hiding? It's just a thought. Like, is hiding an option? Your alien isolation skills.
He is not having a good time right now.
Ah. What do they say, Andrew? Third time's the charm. Thank you. Now I'm hearing that sound again. It kind of reminds me of like someone flipping the breaker in like a warehouse, and every light slowly, individually, as it goes down the room, every light just turns on. Like, it's weird that a light has to make that boom, boom, as every light on the road turns on. I don't know if that's real or just the movies, but I really have not ever had that happen in real life. I hear a lot of tapping on the keyboard over there with Brad. There's that whirling sound. And where's the cliche chase music? That's new. So I was listening to the radio the other day, and they were talking about more shortages. Talking about there's going to be a turkey and ham shortage. There's a ham shortage. I haven't ate ham in forever. I might have ham-based products, but actual ham, I haven't had actual ham in quite some time. I've had my first donut in a while. Yeah, about first time in like a year. It was just classic chocolate glazed. Because it was my boss's birthday, but they got a dozen donuts from a local bakery, Sweet Nana's, I think it's called. I really wanted something to eat. I wait till a certain time to have lunch, and it was still ways off. So I gave in. I was like, okay, no, I'll have a donut. And then about 30 minutes later, something else came from the same bakery. There's a little, I forget what they're called, there's just a little tiny cake. It wasn't a cupcake, it was something else. There's the chase music. Did you make it? Okay, he made it. Our communication is Andrew claps 3 for yes, 2 for no, because that's how many letters are in the word. I got thinking that that form of communication, Andrew, wouldn't work if we were Spanish.
Mm-hmm.
Are you green?
I'm not green with anything.
Phone that's like that dead line sound.
It's 8:00 right now.
I don't mean that.
Streaming for about almost an hour, 52 minutes right now.
I didn't want to have to do this to you. But you can't leave. Not yet. There is so much yet for you to witness. Will you see it? Can you? Our Lord, the Wall Rider, tearing his truth into the unbelievers. The only way out of this place is the truth. Accept the gospel. All doors will open before you.
and now it's silent. Still shut. Bandana is pushing against my left eye, which just hurts sometimes. That pressure. That feels better. I have a bandana that I keep in my back pocket. Use that to line me because keep my eyes shut. Just adds pressure. It hurts a little bit. Like someone's being tortured.
God damn it! What the fuck is the matter with you? You weren't invited to this, you goddamn sicko! It's sick. You're sick.
barely hear what was said. Something about sicko.
Now, I've just noticed that Andrew, the one who's mute, his mic's still powered on for some reason.
That was very violent.
I like you to stay quiet.
Fred squirming. He doesn't seem too scared. Not because I'm blindfolded. It's just Fred's not reacting.
Yeah.
window. I'm just thinking Andrew's reaction, how he just keeps, like, slapping his leg or whatever. It makes me want to make fun of him and be like, hey, does this music slap or something? So at work day at the pet store, we were talking. I walked into the office where my coworker and our social media handler is, and I walked into a conversation. The social media handler was like, "Where do hamsters come from?" And so the person, my coworker, Google searched it, and apparently the golden Syrian hamster is native to Syria. And she's like, it's so weird to think that hamsters are native to the wildlife. Like in Syria, some parts of Europe. I was like, well, that's because we're so used to the modern idea of it being domesticated. You would never expect to see a hamster out in the wild. You would think to see like a field mouse or a sewer rat, but a hamster is just a mystery. And then I was like, which. A hamster be out in the wild reminds me of Pokemon. Cause Morpeko. It's a hamster. Where's that dead phone signal again? Yeah, Brad, I'm not sure if you've been keeping up with it, but I'm disappointed in Pokemon Go?
No, I haven't.
Because, I assumed with all the costume Pokemon that have been popping up this year, especially all the Pikachus, Mimikyu was going to be introduced. Instead, the Halloween event for the year was another Yah mask.
That we did. I'd say
yeah, I haven't played in months, but maybe I should get back into it.
I haven't played in a while either. I just know because one of my various constant notifications. Plus, been trying to keep up with Serebii on the upcoming Scarlet and Violet news.
Yeah. Last time I loaded up Pokemon Go was back when we were up at the zoo. I loaded it up once. I haven't touched it since. I don't even know if I still have it here on my phone.
I wonder how many people are still thinking, yeah, Pokemon Scarlet and Violet, where the heck is our Pokemon Sleep?
I don't think many people are really thinking of that.
I don't think any sort of statement has ever been released saying, yeah, we shut that project down.
I think that game has been dead in the water for a while now.
Uh-huh. That don't sound good.
I don't even know what the hell's going on right now.
Sounds like you're dead. Are you dead? Yep, he's dead.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it doesn't seem like he's having a good time. It's 8:25 right now. We've been streaming for about an hour and 15 minutes.
Are you not getting the results you wanted? So after we leave here, we're gonna finish the stream.
Mm-hmm.
And at some point we're gonna go watch The Amazing Race. I think the only thing I'm looking forward to is just find out who got COVID. Because in the preview from last week, the cliffhanger in the preview was that someone got COVID.
Yeah. I know I could do some sleuthing online to find out who got COVID, but I didn't. So I
sounds like he died. It's been an hour 30. At least an hour 15. Andrew, if there's ever a point where you feel like you don't want to go any further, just slap frantically.
Yeah, I think he's had enough.
Yeah, I've had enough of this game. Oh my god.
I'll unmute him.
I muted him earlier and then he unmuted himself.
Yes, because what are you going to do if I laugh or yelp? Like, you don't want to pick that up?
Well, we muted everybody else.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Yeah, fuck. I don't know, man. This is.
Jesus Christ.
Like, this game is a lot more frustrating than scary.
Yeah. I could tell that.
Yeah.
I was hoping for more reaction from Brad.
Yeah, Mr. Brad, who could still hear and was playing on the computer. I should have made you sit over here and put some music on my Steam Deck. You could have listened to something on my Steam Deck. I thought about doing that, but then I was like, no, it's all right. He's got this. I should have fucking known.
Was I right? I called him out.
No, I was laughing because right before you said that, he was like, yeah, if I wasn't streaming, I'd be playing Planet Zoo right now, but it's kind of an intensive game.
Because I couldn't hear Brad for some parts of it because he was mumbling.
Yeah.
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 I don't know if he was mumbling when he was facing the mic because his back's turned towards me.
I don't know. I think for the most part I was facing into the mic when I was speaking.
Yeah. It's because I'm hard of hearing, so.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah, I'm just. Yeah, no. No.
Play a little bit just so I can see what's going on.
Okay, so actually, what? Actually, I'm gonna die on purpose now that I know what to do. Yeah, come on, kill me.
A face only a mother can love.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. There are some people who are into this.
But I'm saying that face is only a face a mother can love.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so basically, like right before this, I pressed a button to activate this area in front of me. And then this guy comes in and starts breaking the window. And you're supposed to come up here. And I didn't see it for the first couple times. But, like... Like, when the alarm first went and I heard him stomping, I immediately hid, like, behind the file cabinet, because I thought I was supposed to hide. And I didn't realize, but the guy was, like, crashing through that window, and he was behind me, so I didn't fucking see him. So that's, like, when you heard me go, like, what? I looked, and he was, like, right in front of me. I'm like, what the hell, where did this guy come from? So that makes a bit more sense. But yeah, I just, yeah, I'm...
And
yeah.
That music that's playing, the...
Yeah. All right.
It's so cliche.
Yeah.
Ah! Good job, Andrew.
Damn it.
All right, we're done here.
See you next time, folks.